Suppose we have two different types of materials, each with a different wave velocity. Each time a wave transitions into a material where the speed is different, a fraction of the wave is reflected back. The fraction of the wave that is reflected depends on the wave velocities inside the two materials. Let's keep the wave velocity inside the middle material equal to 1, but increase the wave velocity inside the blue material. Let's now again keep the velocity inside the middle material equal to 1, but increase the wave velocity inside the blue material even further. Can you predict how the results will be different this time? In each of the following scenarios, the velocity inside the middle material will continue to be equal to 1, but we will keep increasing the wave velocity inside the blue material. For the first several scenarios, the velocity inside the blue material is still slower than the velocity in the middle material. In these cases, notice how the wave inside the middle material is flipped upside down each time it reflects. Each time a wave transitions into a material where the speed is different, a fraction of the wave is reflected back. The fraction of the wave that is reflected depends on the wave velocities inside the two materials. If the two velocities are almost equal, then the reflected wave is very small. If the two velocities are exactly equal, then the wave just passes straight through, as if the two materials are the exact same material. Now, for the first time, we have a scenario where the wave velocity inside the middle material is slower than the wave velocity in the blue material. When the wave velocity inside the middle material is slower than the wave velocity in the blue material, the situation is fundamentally different. For example, notice how the wave inside the middle material now reflects without being flipped upside down. Let's consider one last scenario like this. Let us now consider a scenario where a wave reaches the end of a material with nothing connected to it. This can mathematically be thought of as the following. The total wave is equal to the sum of the initial wave and a reflected wave of the same amplitude. Therefore, at the end of the material, the total amplitude is momentarily double the amplitude of the initial wave. Let's now consider what happens when the end of the material is fixed in place. This can mathematically be thought of as the following. The total wave is equal to the sum of the initial wave and a reflected wave of the same amplitude flipped upside down. Therefore, at the end of the material, the total amplitude is always zero. The blue material, which is fixed in place, can be mathematically described as a material in which the wave velocity is zero. Let's define the wave velocity inside the material on the left as V1, and the wave velocity inside the material on the right as V2. The amplitude for the reflected wave can be described through this equation. If V1 is equal to 1 and V2 is equal to 0, then the equation gives us the following. We get a reflected amplitude equal to the initial amplitude multiplied by negative 1, which means that the reflected wave is the same amplitude as the initial wave, but flipped upside down. The amplitude for the wave transmitted into the blue material can be described through this equation. If V1 is equal to 1 and V2 is equal to 0, then the equation gives us the following. We get a transmitted amplitude of 0, which means that no wave is transmitted into the blue material. Let's consider a scenario where V1 is still equal to 1, but we increase V2 to slightly above 0. Let us consider another scenario where V1 is again equal to 1, but V2 is slightly higher than in the previous scenario. In each of the following scenarios, V1 is always equal to 1, but we keep increasing V2. Now, let us consider what happens when V1 is equal to V2. The reflected wave is zero, which means that there is no reflection. The transmitted wave is equal to the initial wave, which means that the wave just keeps moving unchanged. Now let's consider what happens when V2 is larger than V1. The reflected wave is now positive, which means that it is not flipped upside down. The transmitted wave is now larger than the initial wave. What will happen as we increase V2 even further? The amplitude of the reflected wave is higher than in the previous scenario. The amplitude of the transmitted wave is higher than the previous scenario. As we keep increasing V2, the amplitudes of the reflected and transmitted waves keep increasing, but the effects get less and less noticeable. As V2 keeps increasing, the amplitude of the reflected wave gets closer and closer to the amplitude of the initial wave, but never exceeds it. As V2 keeps increasing, the amplitude of the transmitted wave gets closer and closer to double the amplitude of the initial wave, but never exceeds this value. As V2 keeps increasing, the amplitude of the reflected wave gets closer and closer to the amplitude of the initial wave, but never exceeds it. If we ignore Albert Einstein's theory of relativity and just use classical physics, then as V2 approaches infinity, we approach the situation we had when there was nothing connected on the right side. For the velocity in the blue material to approach infinity, its mass density needs to approach zero. If the mass density of the blue material is zero, then this is the same thing as there being nothing connected on the right side. Everything in this video assumes that the velocity of a wave in the materials does not depend on the wavelength. What happens when this assumption is false is explained in the video titled Phase Velocity versus Group Velocity, Wave Dispersion. Special thanks to all the people supporting this channel on Patreon. Your support is very much appreciated.